absolutely delighted to have two very beautiful, two very different, but there are, I suppose, resonances between the two exhibitions. We have upstairs in Gallery 2, we have Meta Murmuration by Joanna Kidney, and here we have paintings, I think we called it. two very, very beautiful exhibitions, and just really want to thank both artists so much for the opportunity to show the work, and really delighted with the results. Joanna was installing for 2 weeks, and there's thousands and thousands of hours of work in the making of Metamurmuration. That is even before it's installed, but I think what comes through for me is the care and the beauty of the individual elements, and then as it is installed and as it is occupies the space, it is a thing of beauty in itself, as well as this certain other feeling sometimes, which is almost like the feeling that you get when you see or touch dead hair or hair that has been shorn from the head. In one way, hair is beautiful and, you know, luxurious and a sign of beauty and all the rest. And when it's on the hairdresser, the ground of the hairdresser, or sometimes that has been used in sculpture, like Alice Marr's sculptures, it becomes quite repulsive. So in some ways, Metamurmuration, even though sometimes it is like that murmuration of birds or and that beauty, that form, and sometimes too for me, it's like a swarm of flies, so it's got that depth to it, in that it could change the blink of an eye. And I think it's really, thrilling for that, and it's just wonderful to have here. So Joanna, thanks so much through all the stuff that had to happen and all the stuff that you've done for spending 2 weeks here and for installing this and for the opportunity to have it here for several weeks until the 10th of April. I just want to thank all the people that supported Joanna in installing the exhibition here, our wonderful team here, staff team that worked so hard and done everything to replace Stephen for a time, and also the assistance and support of the students from the BAVA course, both the current students and graduates of the BAVA course, and Sherman committed to also to assist. And also then, David, thank you for thank you so much for speaking and for giving us an insight into your work and for, again, this really beautiful, beautiful exhibition. I can't wait to spend time with it, because I think this exhibition will reward time spent with it. There's a lot of looking here. And a lot of time to be spent here, and I'm looking forward to that. So thank you very much for the opportunity to do that. So just both of you, congratulations and well done, and again, thank you so much. And I'd also just like to thank Sarah Ruttle. I don't know if Sarah's here, for developing Discovery Box, which is a resource for families around David's exhibition, and I look forward to seeing the treasures that she has in that box, which will help and support families to spend time together, spend time at the exhibition, and explore it in a fun way. And now also another thank you to Sarah Baum for coming here this evening and for agreeing to officially open tonight's exhibitions. Sarah is a writer and an artist, and it is a real pleasure to have her here, and I'm looking forward to hearing what she has to say about the exhibitions. Thank you very much.
It's going to be brief, and I was one of the certain people who couldn't make it on Saturday, so it's lovely to still be able to be here. It's funny, my little speech is a little bit about that. It's 5 minutes, I promise, 5 minutes. So whenever I'm charged with tasks like these, I do a bit of homework, and I tend to find that the artists are the kind of artists who have a gracious antipathy to words, which is always at once intriguing and terrifying. And indeed, on David's website, there's a wonderful quote from the poet Paul Valery, which goes, "Anything we can define distinguishes itself instantly from the productive spirit and is opposed." So I tend to find that the only and safest way to proceed, mostly with writing a text, is to approach the work as openly as possible, to make a point of contact, and then to tell a story about that point of contact, with the intention that by giving an honest account of what held my attention, it will then hold the attention of others. So last Tuesday, exactly a week ago now, I came in and met Joanna and witnessed the installation in a partially decomposed state. And we talked about journeys, the journey of tens of thousands of starlings from Scandinavia and Russia to Timaliege, the journey of each separate starling within the murmuration, swooping in perfect instinctive synchronicity, and then the journey of the installation itself, of each separate string and each separate felt burr which makes up each string, and each separate set of fingers, strangers, friends, from Bray to Utah, which made the felt birds. And all of the conversations and connections and confessions made during its making. And then finally, the artist of the journey, or the journey that the artist wants you to take through the installation itself for this space, beginning down here by the cafe, and then going up the stairs, and then along the balcony and in a loop around where it accumulates. In the window and then back again, paying attention to the places where it ebbs and flows, rises and falls, straggles and accumulates. And then on my journey home in the van that evening, it started to snow. And the landscape was obscured by shapeless, listless marks, somehow managing to add up to a great stillness. And this sort of somehow cemented my point of contact with meta-murmuration. And then I was snowed in for 4 days, sitting at my freezing desk, growing increasingly anxious that I hadn't been able to see David's paintings in the flesh. Instead, I'm staring at electronic reproductions of works that are so much and so simply about their own physical presence, about mass and fabric and labor and materiality and machinery. And then I'm staring out the window at this utterly blanked out landscape, this view like an enormous wraparound Robert Reinemann painting, floundering for a point of contact. And it wasn't until Saturday, when the snow finally started to melt, that I started to find, it feels, David's paintings, only in reverse. As the white disintegrated and the layers dissolved, offcuts, fragments, debris started to reveal itself. Frayed strands of blue rope, the innards of a skinned tennis ball, the highest, pointiest bits of bramble bushes, beginnings. And then subdued colors and subtle patterns. And finally, a profound sense of the transience of everything and the dual sadness and glory of decay. And then all of Joanna's starlings descended to pick over the defrosting field, bringing everything together and bringing me neatly to where I am now. So it is with great pleasure that I officially declare, that's what we do, this exhibition.
Joanna is going to give a talk on Saturday the 24th of March. Joanna's also worked with our dance artist residence, Helga Deasy. And Helga is going to give a dance response to meta-murmuration on the same day. So starting at 12, Helga will give a response, and that will be followed by Joanna speaking about the work, and then Helga will repeat that that response, and then later again in the day, I think. So you're all very welcome to come and to on that Saturday to hear Joanna speak about the work and to see what Helga's interpretation of the piece is. Thank you.